Procrastination. I haunt pages, stand around loitering, stare at empty words, and interest in nothing. Lines and lines draw my parallel gates or solitary paths, pointing to a wisdom unwritten here. I loiter. The word is small, but spreads its ending, seeps into the margins, where it all hides, these untold stories and spectacular insights, waiting to be told, trapped in the fold. Pure seconds. This day, this hour, pure seconds dissolving, bubbles of mesmerizing color, undistilled dreamlike swirls, hope saved and watered, treasured like encrusted gold. We blow memories out to sea, stones tripping grey waters, never singing, almost flying, as though they had wings. This is called your close-up. Your close-up. Are you ready for your close-up? I asked if you are ready to be told what to see, hear, to feel, to be, to try not to be, if it isn't the norm. Welcome to the storm of glass figments, waves of imagined blue unfolding, the cares and fears you dreamed of yesterday when we were other people. You entertain ghosts of your waking, reflections of yourself while you sleep, forgetting you are ever so afraid of being you.
It was many and many a year ago, in a kingdom by the sea, that a maiden there lived whom you may know by the name of Annabel Lee. And this maiden she lived with no other fault than to love and be loved by me. I was a child, and she was a child, in this kingdom by the sea. But we loved with a love that was more than love, I and my Annabel Lee, with a love that the winged seraphs of heaven coveted her and me. And this was the reason that long ago, in this kingdom by the sea, a wind blew out of a cloud, chilling my beautiful Annabel Lee, so that a high-born kinsman came and bore her away from me, to shut her up in a sepulchre in this kingdom by the sea. The angels not half so happy in heaven when envying her and me. Yes, that was the reason, as all men know, in this kingdom by the sea, that the wind came out of the cloud by night, chilling and killing my Annabel Lee. But our love, it was stronger by far than the love of those who were older than we, of many far wiser than we, and neither the angels in heaven above, nor the demons down under the sea, could ever dissever my soul from the soul of the beautiful Annabel Lee. For the moon never beams without bringing me dreams of the beautiful Annabel Lee, and the stars never rise, but I feel the bright eyes of the beautiful Annabel Lee. And so all the night tide I lie down by the side of my darling, my life and my bride, in her sepulchre there by the sea, in her tomb by the sounding sea.
Bats. Balancing the curve, dark flits of striking wings dip low to fan out, riding the tugging wind. A quiet bunch, so still, hangs eerily suspended like plastic, unelastic, for you can't pull it back. Looping under bridges, the group swoops and soars to surf the scooping air on invisible boards. Their invisible dances exit on a haphazard line of chattering, high-pitched letters to the moon. Breath. A warm gust in this chill air tells us that we breathe. When unsure if we have stopped, but we are here, a little distant, a little worn. Our breath tells us we remain, making an impression on silence. cobwebbed rooms. A lies linger on, hidden and unwritten, translucent phantoms lost in rooms closed off. Cobwebbed messages seal up passageways with unread notes to the discordant air. A piano plays without heart, a murmur. The chase could not find themselves. Bare histories clump the rusted air, folded chair. Late for dinner, the proud table stands alone, empty astride once polished scarlet stone. They steam tea, slice watery cucumbers, counting days to the sun and moon, wandering ancient pathways so overgrown. Dank moss and weeping brook blanketed by the willow's green locks. It all flickers, disarmed, locked away in another time.